Now I wish to start with one sum on partnership accounts. Just observe the sum on the screen. Krutika and Bhumika are partners of a firm, sharing profits and losses in the proportion of 4:1. Total profit of the firm for the year ended on 31st October 2005 is 22,500. After distributing the profits, it was realized that interest on capital at the rate of 5% per annum was not given to the partners. During the year, Bhumika withdrew 4,000 rupees and Krutika rupees 7,500. On 31st of March 2005, the balance of their capital account were 24,000 and 12,000 respectively. On the basis of our particulars prepared, revised, collected profit and loss appropriation account showing proper distribution of capital accounts and capital accounts of the partners again. Now here there is an error. What is the error? Interest on capital is not given and profit is distributed. And the after distribution of profit, closing capital balance after distribution of capital is found out. Now we want to give the effect of interest on capital which was omitted. For that, one method is to write the rectification entry. So allow interest on capital, credit partners capital account, and whatever the interest on capital is there, that is to be treated as loss and distribute that loss amongst the same partners in their profit sharing ratio. So this is how rectification entry could be made. But in this sum we are not asked to write the rectification entry, but we are required to prepare profit and loss account and capital accounts once again as if no error has occurred. That is what is expected. Now here you are given the capital balance as on 31st 2005. Now this is the closing balance of capital account. Interest on capital was not calculated. Interest on capital gets calculated on the opening balance. Opening balance is not given to you. So first of all, we are required to find the opening balance of partners capital account. After that, we shall revert the sum once again. Means we shall prepare profit and loss appropriation account and capital accounts once again. Now observe it. Steps to solve the sum. Find the opening balance of capital account. Now step 2. Write the opening balance of capital account in capital accounts. Then write the balance of net profit in the profit and loss appropriation account. Write the capital balance as opening capital that we have worked out, that is to be written in the capital account as opening balance. Identify the adjustment, which was the adjustment that was omitted. After distributing the profit, it was realized that the 5% interest on capital is not given. So that is the adjustment that was omitted, error of omission, that will be considered now. After that, you have to distribute the profit. So let us first work out the opening balance of capital account. Now we know the formula. This is the formula generally we apply while preparing final accounts, and that too we display this on the liability side of the balance sheet to report the capital. The formula is opening capital minus drawings plus profit is equal to closing balance. Now closing balance is given to me. Profit also I know. Drawings also know. I don't know the opening balance of capital account. So what I want to do? To find out the opening balance of capital account, I rewrite the equation. And I make opening capital as a subject of equation. So closing capital plus drawings minus profit. This is the formula to find out the opening capital. Let me apply this formula in this table. And let us find out the opening capital of Krutika and Bhumika. Now see. Closing capital given to you in the sum is 24,000 and 12,000. Now we are required to add drawings. Drawings are given to us in the sum. How much? 4,000 and 7,500. So 7,500 and 4,000. 7,500 is for Krutika. So write for Krutika 7,500. For Bhumika 4,000. They have altered the sequence. Be aware of it. Now, profit was distributed. That was distributed in the ratio of 4:1. So 20,500 was distributed in the ratio of 4:1. I will find out the share of each partner. That is 18,000 and 4,500. If you deduct the profit therefrom, here you will get by difference the opening balance of capital account. On this opening balance of capital account, interest on capital gets calculated. Now, after finding out this opening balance of capital account, let us prepare the profit and loss appropriation account and capital account as usual. Now see, observe. Write the balances. So net profit. Balance of profit and loss account is net profit that appears on the credit side of profit and loss appropriation account. Let me write it. Then I have found out the opening balance of capital account that will be recorded to the credit side of partner's capital account. This 13,000 and 11,500 is the opening balance of capital account. Let me write it down. Now on this balance, interest on capital will be granted. Let us calculate and give its effect, give its accounting effect. Now 13,500 into 5%, that is credit into capital account of Krutika and debit into profit and loss appropriation account. So profit and loss appropriation account is debited with 675. And Krutika's capital account is credited with 675, that is 5% interest on capital. Now let us work out for Bhumika. That's 11,500 into 5%. 575, second effect. Profit and loss appropriation account debit to partner's capital account credit. Now interest on capital which was omitted, now it's given. Now, I want to find out the divisible profit. So 22,500 minus 1,250 will be the divisible profit. But here as I have written the opening balance of capital accounts, so I should write down the drawings of partners. So drawings of Bhumika 4,000, that of Krutika 7,500. Now I will distribute the divisible profit amongst partners in the aggregate ratio. Observe it. 22,500 minus 1,250, this is the divisible profit, 21,250. Now this 21,250 will be distributed in the ratio of 4:1. So 21,250 into 4/5, 17,000. Share of Krutika, share of Bhumika means B, 1/5. 4,250, profit and loss appropriation account debit to partner's capital account credit. I have credited partner's capital account with the divisible profit. Now I will close the capital accounts. Total of credit side of Krutika, 31,175. From that deducted 7,500. So 23,675 is the balance carried forward. Total of credit side of Bhumika 16,325. From 16,325 deduct 4,000. So 12,325 is the balance. This balance, closing balance, becomes opening balance for the next period. So balance brought forward 23,675 and 22,325. This is how this sum is solved. I feel that you must have understood this sum. Thanks to all of you.